Now eventually we get to the very exciting world of using trigonometric substitution into normal integration. And I'm going to start with this table which you just have to know by heart. There's simply no other way. Let's just look at it. You might not understand exactly what it means now, but as we run through a few examples, you'll understand why. If your integral problem contains the square root of a squared minus x squared, instead of using u substitution, then use trigonometric substitution and let x equals a cosine of theta or a sine of theta. If you do that and you take the derivative of x with respect to theta, you're going to be left with a sine theta or a cosine theta, depending on what you substituted x with. If your integral problem contains the square root of a squared plus x squared, you're going to substitute with x as a tangent of theta, and that a comes from the a squared, and you will get a secant of theta. And lastly, if your integral problem contains this factor, the square root of x squared minus a squared, substitute x as a secant of theta, and you will be left with a times the tangent of theta. How does this work? Let's do an example. Let's start here. We are asked to get the indefinite integral of 1 over x squared times the square root of 1 plus x squared. All of this with respect to x. How on earth to tackle this problem with u substitution or any other form of integration? But let's look, 1 plus x squared. Let's look at that, 1 plus x squared. Well, that is the same as 1 squared plus x squared, where a equals 1 now. And there we have such an example, number 2, a squared plus x squared. So we are going to substitute x with the tangent of theta. Let's do that. Let us say x equals the tangent of theta. If we now take the derivative of x with respect to theta, what are we left with? Well, we learned that in videos past. The first derivative of the tangent of an angle is secant squared of theta. And if we get x dx on its own, we are left with the secant squared of theta d theta. Now, if we have 1 plus x squared, that's because that's what we have in our problem, and we substituted x as the tangent of theta, that is going to equal 1 plus the tangent squared of theta. And we know what that is from previous videos, that is the secant squared of theta. But we are asked to get the square root of 1 plus x squared. So that will equal the square root of the secant squared of theta, and that just equals the secant of theta. So now let's substitute back into our problem. Let's move up a bit. So now we are left with 1 over x squared, that now will be tangent squared of x, tangent squared of theta, sorry, and the square root of 1 plus x squared, there we have it, that equals the secant of x. So over the secant of theta, or dx, there we have dx, so that is going to be secant squared theta d theta. We can simplify this. That secant square in the numerator and a secant in the denominator, so we are left with secant of theta divided by the tangent squared of theta, all with respect to theta. Well, this can be simplified even further. What is the secant of an angle? Well, that is 1 over the cosine of an angle. 1 over the cosine of that angle, and we have the tangent squared, tangent squared of an angle, well, that is the sine squared of that angle divided by the cosine squared of that angle. But tangent here, remember, is in the denominator. So if we rewrite this, we're going to get secant. We said we're going to get 1 over the cosine of that angle times, and we're going to that is in the denominator, so we swap those around. That is going to be cosine squared of theta divided by the sine squared of theta. All of this with respect to theta. This can be simplified even further. So we are going to be left with the indefinite integral of the cosine of theta divided by the sine squared of theta d theta. Now we have to use u substitution. It's cosine and sine. We know how to do this. We need to get rid of cosine theta d theta. The antiderivative of cosine would be the sine. And sine appears in our problem in the denominator. So let us say let u equal the sine of theta. So from that we have du d theta is going to be, it's quite easy, that's the cosine of theta. So we have du equaling cosine of theta d theta. Now let us substitute that in. So cosine of theta d theta is going to be a du for us, and that was going to 1 over u squared. 1 over u squared. And that would be the same as, well, let me put it here, that's u to the power negative 2 du. If we add 1 to that, that is negative 1. So we're going to have 1 over negative 1 u to the power negative 1 plus c. And that is simply equals negative 1 over u. But remember what u was. What was u? We said u equals sine of theta, so it's negative 1 over the sine of theta plus c. Now we have to go back from a theta in our problem to our original question, which was asked in the form of an x there. How do we do that? And that is called the reverse of trigonometric substitution. And the way to do that, let's just get to the right spot, the way to do that is through graphical interpretation, through geometry. Let's draw a right triangle. Let us call let's call this angle theta. Now remember, this would be the hypotenuse. This will be opposite, and this will be adjacent. Now when we made our first trigonometric substitution, we let x equal, let me do it in red, the tangent of theta. So let's look at that. If this will go down, come on. Stuck now, there we go. Where are we now? There we go. So we called x equals the tangent of theta. So if x equals the tangent of theta, and what is tangent? It's opposite divided by adjacent. So that is x over 1. That means the opposite has to be x and the adjacent has to be 1 to make the tangent of theta equal to x. This is a right triangle. That means the hypotenuse is 1 plus x squared. 1 squared plus x squared through the Pythagorean theorem. So if we wanted to know now what the sine, remember we've got sine of theta there, the sine of theta is going to be, what is sine? Opposite over hypotenuse, so that is going to be x over the square root of 1 plus x squared. But in our original problem, it is, let's just rewrite it there, it is minus 1 over sine of theta plus c. So if we substitute, we'll get negative the square root of 1 plus x squared divided by x plus c. And that is called reversal of trigonometric substitution. There's also another answer, if we just quickly look if there's time. If we say that the tangent, let me just use another color, if you said that the tangent of theta equals x, that leaves theta as the arc tangent, as the arc tangent of x. So in our problem there, we would have negative 1 over the sine of the arc tangent of x plus c. And both of these are equivalent. We are left with an answer containing x, and that was our original problem.